And welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, as you can see, I'm on vacation in Maui this week, and I'm trying to get some podcasts done before everyone wakes up here. And I have a question from Mike. I realize this podcast is probably going to show on a Friday, and this is probably way too hard to try and do in a single podcast, but let's give it a shot. Mike's trying to set up a checkbook in Excel, and he's using fairly sophisticated tools. He's using data validation for his list of categories. He has a list of all the available categories and set up data validation from a list. For his list of payees, he set up a list of all the previous payees, but turned off the error alerts. That way, if he has a brand new payee, he starts shopping at a new grocery store, for example, validation doesn't give him a problem. But in his check number field, Mike wants to set up validation that says, either I'm entering a check number, which means that we have to use an integer, or it's one of the values that I've used previously. For example, DD for direct deposit, or EFT for electronic funds transfer, or ATM for an ATM withdrawal. And he wants to know how he can set up validation to do that, and do a list drop down as well. Now, I can't do the list drop down, but let's walk through how I can do everything else. In data validation, most of the time I talk about setting up a custom list. This is one of my standard things I do in the Power Excel seminar. But today we're going to use something called custom. And in custom, we have to write a formula that evaluates to true or false. If the answer is true, Excel will allow the value to come in. If it's false, Excel will say, hey, that value is not valid. So we have to write a really complicated formula that's going to handle either situation. The first thing we have to do is see if the value that's entered is a number. We need to see if it's an integer. And the best way to check to see that is to look and see if the integer of the number, int function, is the same as the number. So here I have a simple formula set up that says if B1 is equal to the integer of B1, and you see here we have 1 and a 2, those are true, but a 1.2 or 2.1, those are false, because the integer of 2.1 is 2, which isn't equal to 2.1, and that's a good way to tell whether or not you have an integer. I'm going to go on to the next worksheet, and here I've entered a few different values, EFT, direct deposit, ATM, and my formula here, let's take a look at it down in row 6. My formula says we want to use the COUNTIF function, and basically COUNTIF everywhere from B1, and that's an absolute reference, down to B5, that's the row right before the current row, is equal to the value B6, and we're going to count how many times that happens. If it's a brand new entry, the count will be 0. So basically I want to see if the COUNTIF is greater than 0, and you'll see how this works. So here I have EFT. When I got to the second EFT, the value was true. Second direct deposit, the value is true. ATM, the value is false. But then if I put in ATM again, the value is true. So hopefully in Mike's list, he has a list of all the valid values. So now we have to try and put those two things together. I learned the first time I tried to set this up that if I did the integer trick, if the integer of B2 is equal to B2, and we have a value like direct deposit, that gives me an error. And so I came here to my third worksheet, and I go into data validation. I set up an if formula. If I have a number in B6, then I check to see if B6 is equal to the integer of B6. Otherwise, I do the COUNTIF function, COUNTIF from $B, $1 down to B5, and I have to note that I'm doing this in cell B6. I have to write this formula for the active cell. If it's equal to B6, greater than 0, that basically sets up my formula. I can click OK now, and what I did was I deleted the value in that cell, copied the cell, and pasted it down to however far I think I might be entering check numbers, so that way it copies the formula correctly. Now, what should happen is if I enter a check number like 1, 2, 3, 4, it's perfect. If I enter a check number with a decimal, 1234.1, I get an error. If I enter a value that's already been entered before, ATM, no problem. If I enter a value that's new, it will say you can't do that. Now, Mike wanted a drop down in the cell, and I don't have a good way to do that other than to go to Tools, Options, and on the Edit tab, we look at the bottom checkbox, Enable Autocomplete for Cell Values, and that basically will allow me to type the A and hit Enter, or the D, or the E. This works perfectly because we have only a few values. If we happen to have a really long value in B1, and perhaps a really longer value in B2, that really defeats the whole autocomplete. When I start typing, it doesn't know whether I want really long or really longer, and so until I get to the space, it doesn't fill things in. But really, in Mike's situation here, where we just have ATM, EFT, direct deposit, I'm going to say that using autocomplete will solve the problem. So there you have it. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.